what do you mean by the dielectric? Okay, dielectrics are the insulating material which transmit the electrical effect. Okay, dielectrics are the insulating material which transmit the electrical effect without actually conducting itself. They are called as a dielectrics. Which are the example of dielectrics? Examples of the dielectrics are mica, rubber, wood, glass. All these are the examples of a dielectrics. Okay? ये मुळात dielectrics हे non-conducting substances असतात. त्यांच्यामधून electric current pass होत नाही. But when it is placed in an external field, then the positive and the negative charges are displaced in opposite directions, and that molecule develop a dipole moment, and this process is called as a polarization of the material, and the material are called dielectrics. Okay, what is dielectric? Non-conducting substance. It only transmit the electric effect. Okay, then there are two types of dielectrics: polar dielectrics and the non-polar dielectrics. What do you mean by the polar dielectrics? The molecule in which the center of the positive charge does not coincide with the center of the negative charge due to the asymmetrical shape of molecule. Let us see the example. HCl H2O. Example घेतल्यानंतर तुम्हाला लक्षात येईल. Okay. What is this series? This is the Cl minus and this is the H. Okay. H plus. Okay, this is the center of Cl, this is the center of H. Now, these two centers are charges are well separated. They are not coincide. बरोबर आहे? They are not coincide. इथं कुठेतरी coincide होते. इथं coincide होत नाही. Therefore, it has the value of twice L. Okay, there is some pole length which is the twice L. As there is some pole length twice L, there is an electric dipole moment which is nothing but a P, and the direction of electric dipole moment is from minus to the plus. Okay, therefore this is the well example of the HCl. This is आपल्याला H2O च्या बाबतीत सुद्धा म्हणता येईल. Now non-polar dielectrics. Okay, एक लक्षात ठेवायचं की dielectrics चे दोन टाइप्स. Polar dielectrics have a permanent dipole moment. Okay, due to the asymmetrical shapes of the molecule. Now second one is non-polar dielectrics. In non-polar dielectrics, what happen? A molecule in which the center of positive charge coincide with the center of mass of the negative charge. Okay, therefore they have the don't possess any dipole moment due to the symmetrical shapes of molecule. Example is CO2, N2, O2. Okay, suppose this is the carbon, this is the O, oxygen, oxygen. Okay, the center of C is this, center of O is this, center of O is this. The center of these two oxygen molecule, okay, coincide with the center of a C. The charges are not separated, okay, because both the charges, positive charge and negative charge, can be like coincide the line. Therefore, N is equal to 0. As the pole length is equal to 0, P is equal to the 0. Therefore, this non-polar dielectric doesn't possess the any dipole moment. Okay? Therefore, you can distinguish between the polar dielectric and non-polar dielectrics. Okay? The molecules have the asymmetrical shape. This has the symmetrical shape. Okay? Then again, it has the permanent dipole moment and it has the zero dipole moment. Okay. Now, next one is the polarization of a polar dielectric in an external field. तुम्हाला दोन फिगर आहे दिसत असतात. In first figure, what happened? In the absence of electric field, then what happened? Due to the thermal agitations, all the dipole moments are randomly oriented and therefore dipole moment is zero. In the case of a polar dielectric, in the absence of external field. When we apply the external field to the polar dielectric, then what happens? All the dipole moments are aligned in the direction of external electric field, and therefore dipole get polarized. Therefore, here is the sum value of the dipole moment. Here, P is not equal to the zero. Okay, because all the dipole moments are aligned in the direction of a external electric field, which is nothing but a E zero. The direction of the E zero. और ऊपर सगळे ने काय केले अलाइनमेंट केलेली आहे आणि सर्व डायपोल मूवमेंट हे कसे आहेत तर इट इज इन द डिरेक्शन ऑफ ए एक्सटर्नल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. ओके, नाउ पोलरायझेशन ऑफ ए नॉन पोलर डायलेक्ट्रिक इन एन एक्सटर्नल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. ओके, नाउ फर्स्ट केस मध्ये आपण काय केलेलं आहे तर नॉन पोलर डायलेक्ट्रिक कन्सिडर केलेली आहे. ओके, कारण नॉन पोलर डायलेक्ट्रिक मध्ये काय असतात दोन्हीचे सेंटर से कोइनसाइड्स असतात. इन द अब्सेंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड देन व्हाट हॅपन दिस डायपोल नॉन पोलर डायलेक्ट्रिक डजंट शो एनी डायपोल मूवमेंट. ओके, देन इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड व्हेन वी अप्लाय द एक्सटर्नल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड टू द नॉन पोलर डायलेक्ट्रिक्स देन व्हाट हॅपन्स द सेंटर ऑफ द पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज electric field and the negative charges are moved in the opposite directions. Okay, and therefore internally the electric field is induced. That electric field is the EI, induced electric field. Therefore we can say that the net field E is equal to the applied field E zero minus EI. Okay, this is the important equations where E zero is nothing but a applied electric field. EI is the induced electric field. Therefore, E is equal to the E0 minus EI. Okay. This is the effect of dielectric in the absence of electric field and in the presence of electric field. From these two points, you can say that both the polar and non-polar dielectric develop a net mag dipole moment. Okay. From this two points you can say that both the polar and non-polar molecules develop a net dipole moment. Then what do you mean by the polarization? Okay, polarization means the net electric dipole moment per unit volume is called as a polarization. पोलराइजेशन ही टर्म आलेली. देन व्हाट इज द पोलरायझेशन? पोलरायझेशन मीन्स इट इज डिनोटेड बाय पी वेक्टर अँड इट इज द नेट इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल मूवमेंट पर युनिट व्हॉल्यूम. ओके, एज द फॉर लिनियर आइसोट्रोपिक डायलेक्ट्रिक्स दिस पी इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द ई अँड देअरफॉर पी इज इक्वल टू द काय इन टू ई वेअर काय इज द electric susceptibility of the material and it is different for different materials. Okay, this is all about the polarization. Okay, now next point is reduction of electric field due to the polarization of a dielectric. Okay, here we consider the dielectric slab. Okay, and here the electric field is applied to the dielectric slab. Then what happens in this case is actually there is a no motion of charges. Dielectric मध्ये motion of charges ही होत नाही. फक्त बसले जागीच ते काय करतात ते मूव करतात. जसे कंडक्टर मध्ये चार्जेस काय होतात हे मूव होतात इलेक्ट्रॉन्स मूव होतात परंतु इथं चार्जेस ने मूव होत नाही. इट इज द स्लाइटली रीअरेंजमेंट ऑफ द चार्जेस विद इन द एटम्स. ओके, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ पोलरायझेशन निगेटिव्ह चार्जेस आर डेव्हलप ऑन वन साइड अँड पॉझिटिव्ह चार्जेस आर डेव्हलप ऑन द अदर साइड. ओके, ही एक्सटर्नल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड आहे हे लक्षात घ्या. दिस इज प्लस मायनस. एक्सटर्नल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड आपण कशाला वापरलेली आहे? डायलेक्ट्रिक स्लॅबला वापरलेली आहे. त्याच्यामुळे काय होतं? ऍक्च्युली देर इज अ नो मोशन ऑफ चार्जेस बट देर इज अ स्लाइट rearrangement of the charges within the dielectrics, and therefore due to the polarization negative charges are on the left hand side and positive charges are on the right hand side. Okay, and therefore there is a induced electric field which is the ER. Here is again the field is induced, internal field is induced, that field is nothing but a ER. Therefore we can say that again net field is equal to the E0 minus ER. E is equal to the net field, E0 is the applied field, and ER means the induced field due to the where the dielectric slab is kept in an electric field. Okay, then greater the applied field, of course greater is the polarization field. Does it mean electric field is just the greater for applied field? E0 is the greater as said, the ER is the greater as the right. And when we remove this applied field, the induced dipole moment disappears. Induced dipole moment disappears. Okay, this is all about the dielectrics. This dielectric concept is used for the capacitor, which is very important electrical device which can store the electric charge. Okay, we will see in next lectures. Let us stop here.